Well, hi everyone, and welcome to Community Journal. Thank you very much for joining us. We have an interesting show for you today. And as you can see, we are quite decorated this morning.
Yes, we certainly are.
And Paul is off today, but you know, we are really quite festive. I mean, it's amazing.
Would you like me to explain why, Jack?
Well, I think maybe we should. Before you do, Eileen, I have to just comment.
Yes.
After 108 years, I have to say, the Chicago Cubs did a wonderful thing. They really did.
I mean, stayed up to see the whole thing.
So as a result, if we're not quite as sharp as we normally are, not that we are that sharp anyway, but today we're substandard because we stayed up all night to watch that game, but it was well worth it.
Oh, it really was. Oh, how exciting for them. I remember when the Red Sox won after, what, 86 years or 88 years? Back in 2004, it was such an exciting thing for our city, and I can just imagine how the Chicagoans are feeling.
Yes. Well, the decorations that you see, obviously, are from the Garden Club of Harwich.
Yes, they are. And I have two lovely ladies here next to me, very festively dressed and ready for the holiday season. And our chair down at the very end there of the Harwich Garden Club Boutique Committee is Barbara Obrick. And next to her is Lynn Drummond, who is also a co-chair of the Ways and Means Committee for the club. And as you well know from announcements I've made over the years, I'm also a member of the Garden Club. So this boutique is very close to my heart. And Lynn is going to give us a little history of the Garden Club of Harwich. And we have a very exciting anniversary coming up for the club. And there's a reason why she's going to say that, because all of these lovely things in front of us are part of the fundraising that the club does during the year.
That's right.
So Lynn, can you give us a little background?
Sure. Thank you, Jack and Eileen. First of all, we have 175 plus active members, and we would accept some men, but no one has applied yet, unfortunately.
Oh, Jack. Maybe we can work on that.
We need the elbow grease. And this year, 2017, we will be celebrating our 85 years as still working for the town of Harwich. So it's going to be a big year for us. At present, we take care of 19 public gardens in Harwich, and we tend and care for 42 blooming barrels throughout the town. And oftentimes, you see the women carrying jugs of water to keep these plants growing all summer. And this summer, with the drought, it was a tough job.
I did that for many years, and it's not an easy job.
It's
not. It's not a drought.
Right.
Yeah.
And this year, we had two big initiatives. If you remember, we had the aging whiskey barrels, and so we decided to replace them with eco-friendly black planters. And we put in beautiful fresh flowers, and that was a big deal for the club, and we got a lot of compliments. And our other initiative was the plantings, the sustainable gardening plantings at Thompson's Field off of Chatham Road. At this point, everything is self-sustaining, needing less water, and it's called our Native Scape Gardens. And if you don't know who puts up our town wreaths, it's the Garden Club. A lot of people say, well, who does it? Well, we do it. And we also deliver fresh wreaths to all the public buildings. And this entails a lot of little workshops and a lot of hands-on work for the women.
A lot of this starts in the summer.
It does. Oh, yeah.
Because
it does.
There's so much to be done, not just for the holiday boutique, but as Lynn just pointed out, the holiday wreaths and that are hung on the poles and the holiday wreaths that are on the public buildings.
That's right.
Lynn, we've seen the wreaths all over town. Just as an estimate, about how many are there? Because I know there are a lot.
We've done filming of the workshop,
and it's a massive workshop. Yeah, it's almost like an assembly line of the number of wreaths.
Yeah, I think there's at least a couple of dozen.
Yeah,
and the women that work on it are so dedicated.
They are.
They really are.
They really are, and they put together workshops that last year to year. They all come back and help. It's a dedicated group. I've been a member for a short time, and these ladies work hard.
Wow.
And they work hard for the town, and I'm happy to be a part of it. It's great.
That's great.
All of this takes money, and that's the reason why these ladies are here today.
Exactly.
Because the Holiday Boutique is one of the biggest fundraisers that the club has.
And to enable us to keep going, mm-hmm. we need to do these fundraisers. And one more exciting thing, Brooks Museum, we're going to put in a period perennial garden. To bring back the memories of when Sidney Brooks was alive. So that's a new initiative which is going to take place.
That's quite nice.
So knowing what we do, I'm going to turn it over to Barbara to tell us, tell everyone what we have for sale at our boutique.
And before you start, Barbara, I just want to remind people that the stroll weekend in Harwich is usually the first week in the first weekend in December,
right.
And on the Saturday of that weekend, December 3rd, from 9:30 to 1, right here at the Community Center, the Garden Club of Harwich is going to be displaying. These are just small samples of what they're going to have for you to buy at the Holiday Boutique here. So can you tell us a little bit about everything?
Thank you, Eileen. Yes, as Eileen said, this is a small sample. And some of these items people have been making, as Jack mentioned, throughout the whole year to get things ready so we can collect them, inventory them, and know what we have available. For example, if you take a look at that pillow right next to Jack, that's handmade and hand-embroidered by one of our members. It's absolutely magnificent, and that and a match will be available at the boutique for sale. We also have, Jack, by your left hand, a group of scarves, handmade, again, infinity scarves, all different prints. Some of them have bow pins, and they have been very popular year to year, so we will have a great deal of them available. The two sprays that you see here are also made, the bows and the sprays, by one of our members. And this takes a lot of time. I don't know how you folks are with making bows, but I'm not good at this.
No, I'm not either. That's why I was never on that committee.
Exactly. And when you take a look at the work on these, they really are beautiful. They're beautiful and a time saver for people to buy for their homes or to give to someone as a hostess gift or a neighbor's gift or whatever. Eileen is picking up the cocoa mug. That's one sample of what we'll have. It's great fun if you have a grandchild to put one of those maybe in a stocking. They're wonderful.
Just fun. There's cocoa inside.
There is indeed. And again, if you're going to someone's home and they have children, it's a fun thing. You bring a hostess gift, but this is a fun thing if they have children to bring one or two of these for the kids. We then have these two pouches that contain, we're Garden Club, and they contain clippers, and they're very good ones.
Wow.
And you'll notice that the ladies have matched the pouch to the color of the clipper.
That's cute.
Because good. We're good.
Yes, you are.
So we'll have many of these available. In front of Eileen, we have dog kerchiefs, different sizes, large, medium, and small for your pups. And I bought two last year, and we still have them. And they're wonderful, and again, very popular, because you don't want to forget your pet.
Right. That's right.
The ladies have also made these tissue holders, which are kind of fun. We all keep a pack of these tissues in our purse. This is a nice thing to have. It keeps it neat, and it's pretty. So
it's a nice stocking stuffer.
It is. Exactly.
Yes.
Exactly right. And again, many different patterns available. And this is just kind of a one-of-a-kind little bird's nest, bird's house. That is absolutely magnificent.
Isn't that gorgeous? Look at the work in it.
Isn't that incredible?
Really cute, yeah.
And this is just an example of the kind of detail that our members put in to these kind of things to help the club stay healthy and make some nice things available for the people in the community. Here's another example, a shell photo picture, again, handmade, and very detailed and time-consuming to make, and a very beautiful thing to buy.
That would make a nice gift, too, to remind people of a visit they might have had to Cape Cod or whatever.
Yep, that's right, exactly right.
These are cute.
And these are coaster sets, again, that people have made, as Jack said, throughout the year, to compile our stuff and get ready. And again, they are different patterns. And this is kind of fun.
I love that. That caught my eye.
Unfortunately, it's empty. We can have fun later.
Read my mind.
But again, if you're going to someone's house and you're bringing a bottle of wine as a gift, this is kind of a fun thing to put
so
on top.
Oh, cute. Yes, it is.
Instead of a bag, a wine bag, this is just fun and mm-hmm. little whimsy and different.
Mm-hmm.
In the front, you'll see the Christmas tree.
Oh, yeah. Oh yes.
And on that Christmas tree, I'm sure you can't see too much detail, but there are handmade shell ornaments and silver dollar ornaments that our members have collected, have hand decorated, and we have a large inventory of them available because every year they're very popular. You can use them to decorate your tree, and they're also great to decorate gifts. So when you're wrapping and you put your bow, when you want to put something kind of fun, you can put one of those, and then the people will have it always to hang on their tree and remember you by. And
yes.
It's a very nice, thoughtful gift. On this side in the front is a tree that we have placed the bows, more of these gorgeous bows.
Oh.
And this is a very small sample of what we have available. And again, when you go to the store to buy them, they're very basic and very ordinary. These are very ornate, very individual, and absolutely magnificent. So again, these are very popular items, and our members start early in the year to make these because they're so time consuming.
And they do last from year to year, I can attest
they
to that.
They do.
Because
yeah.
I
yes.
have bought them, we yeah. bought them, and mm. you just fluff them up. They're wired
exactly
ribbon.
Exactly right.
You fluff them up each year, and they last.
Exactly
and these
right.
these Infinity scarves, I have several,
yeah.
and I'll tell you, I've gotten more compliments
yep.
on them, and people have asked me, where did I get them?
Yep. Well,
course,
come
I
to the boutique, attagirl. Be out there plugging. And again, this is a small sample. We have many more things. And most importantly, we also have fresh wreaths
yes,
that are going that will be decorated mm. beautifully, and small arrangements, fresh with fresh greens, and larger arrangements with fresh greens. And they are absolutely magnificent every year. So, and again, they go quickly. So people who are coming to the boutique, come early. And
there's always a line.
Yeah,
so I would line up early.
You know, I was just going to yes, bring that
yeah.
point up
yes,
every
yeah,
year that yeah. We've covered this
mm-hmm.
story. The line is amazing at the very beginning when it opens.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are planning to come, come early to get the best selection because
exactly.
the, you know, to get the best selection, that's the time to get there. And but what I'm amazed at is the variety of things that you have.
Yes.
There's just so much, and
something for everyone.
Right.
Exactly right.
Mm-hmm.
It's this year looks really fantastic.
Right.
It really does.
And we will have baked goods.
Oh yes,
oh,
yummy.
Oh yes, yes.
yes. yes.
We can't forget the baked
right.
goods.
Can't
yeah,
those.
Yeah.
They have their own separate line.
Right, right.
And again, everything that will be offered at the bake table will be homemade.
Yeah.
And different things, things that you will not have the time at home to make for yourself. So do make sure you hit that table when you come to the boutique.
And you can pop it in the freezer. Again, I speak
right.
from
yep.
experience.
Yeah.
You can just pull it out and say, oh, yes.
Spoken
see.
Like a working woman.
Just not by me, but I don't say that. Well, thank you both for coming. I know this took a lot of work and time to set all of this up, and I appreciate you coming. And please, in kind, attend the Holiday Boutique for the Garden Club of Harwich here at the Community Center on Saturday, December 3rd from 9:30 to 1. But if you take Jack's hint and my hint, I would be here a good bit before 9:30.
Oh, I think so.
Yes.
Yeah, this
so
looks,
that you can have your choice
yeah.
of what you'd like. So please come and know that this is one of their major fundraisers for the club for the year. And I know so many people have complimented me over time for the black planters and for the whiskey barrels. When
yeah, it's amazing. When we were around town, people say, boy, it really
yes.
looks nice around
yes.
here. And we said, well,
yeah.
that is your garden club mm-hmm. that is doing
that's
that.
That's right.
And,
so show your appreciation and come and support them.
Very good.
Thank
you again, ladies,
thank
for coming
you.
In.
Thank you.
Really
thank you.
Appreciate
thank
it.
You.
And, well, folks, Paul sat down with Carolyn because this past week, we had quite a day here. Of course, it was Halloween. And, of course, in Community Center spirit, there was quite a party here for the kids. And along with that, we do have a Community Center update. So let's take a look now at the Community Center update with Carolyn and Paul.
Welcome to Channel 18, and our first guest today is Carolyn Carey, the director of the Community Center. And Carolyn is here to give a big thank you for all those who worked at the Halloween party. Is that right, Carolyn?
It is very true. There's not even a big enough thank you to say. We had such a nice time. Thank you.
Yes.
You were there. I think most of Channel 18 was there and helping out.
That's right. Even Jamie came along with her little bag.
I'm going to say she was probably trick-or-treating, but she was helping too. She does a great job.
Yes, she does.
We had a wonderful time, and we had so many small children and families come through. But I wanted to take just a moment to say thank you to everyone in the community. When we didn't think we had candy, people came from everywhere just dropping off candy, bringing it to us. The recreation department put out the word, and all of their different clubs and volleyball and pickleball came running in with bags of candy. And then one of the realtors in town put out a tweet, a Facebook posting on his own, and collected it at his office. So to Richard Waystack, thank you. The Chamber of Commerce helped out. The Recreation Department, unbelievable. The Council on Aging. I honestly could not thank people enough. This was one of those times when, I know I have a great job and I say it all the time, but it just unfolds in front of you how wonderful this building is and what it means to the community. Certainly not anything to do with me, but really what it has to do with everyone in it. Mm-hmm. The children who come and have a great time. All the pizzas that were donated, I don't think they get enough appreciation because it's so behind the scenes and the kids are just enjoying it. And the parents then don't have to go home and feed, make dinner and feed them. It's really a one-stop shopping.
Right.
They have ice cream, and this year there was Italian ices. It was a lovely evening for everyone.
I even had some chocolate ice cream.
See, there was chocolate ice cream. It was and it was a safe environment. We had a parade through the gym. There
yes.
was coloring contests. Guess the candy corn. You didn't win again.
I know. Well,
someday you could win, but the
right.
people
someday
that won had a great time.
Now, who did win? Do you remember?
We have their names up front, but they've picked up their prizes and they're very excited about it. It's really all just in good fun.
Yes.
It's nice to see people just participate and have a good time. So, when you walk into the community center, you'll see a very large thank you. We wanted to spend some time and make sure that we put that up. That will appear in the newspaper as well. It's on our website. It was in every child's trick-or-treat bag because, truthfully, I cannot thank the people enough. All of the people who volunteered, that donated, that just put this whole party together and made it happen. One of the groups that doesn't get thanked enough are the people who come in, like yourself, and people who sit at the doors and pass out candy. So thank you, really. This is it's a lot of work for that short 2.5 hour, 3 hour time frame.
It is, right.
But it's really a great time, and we hear the kids talking about it. And I had this year when we were putting out the call to candy, I had somebody drop off a bag of candy, and it might just be my favorite bag of candy. Not because I ate it, I don't even eat the candy, but because this person came in and they're a freshman in college, and he was back and heard that we were looking for it, and he came in and he said, oh, I just wanted to drop this off because I came here when I was a kid. I now feel very old. But I thought, wow, that they want to give back because they had such a good time. So it was just a nice story to go around. So thank you to everyone. Most importantly, make sure that you thank the person next to you because they helped to build this place, and without it we wouldn't be here. So thank you.
Yeah, there you go.
And while we're thanking people, one of the big things we need to do, if I can move on to the next thing.
Yes, you can.
We need to, no matter what your I know it's a crazy election season. We're not even going to talk about that. no matter what your politics are, we always need to support the troops. I don't ever talk politics. I talk supporting our troops. So we have at the front of the building, you'll see these signs and a large box. All we're asking is that you would drop off some things that they might need, and we will make sure it gets to them. The drop-off deadline is November 18th. These are for the troops that are from Cape Cod. So there are some pretty simple things, hats and gloves, batteries, pens and papers, puzzles, books, toothbrushes, toothpaste, shampoo. So again, not huge things, and if you're out in the store and you want to throw something extra in your cart and just drop it off here, we'll make sure. We are working with the Cape Cod Cares for Our Troops program. So you'll see that here at the front. I know I keep coming on telling you all the things that people need, but really,
we do need them.
They do, and remember, you're all home, and they're not, so it's important. Thank you. Thanks for thinking of that. Well, I'm on the subject. I'm sorry. I'm going to keep going. The Lions Club has asked me to mention that once again this year they are collecting coats, and in our front lobby is a large box that has the Lions Club's gently used coats that they give to people that will need them. It's a beautiful day. It's not that cold. I know we're in November, but it is going to change, and the weather will get bad, and people need warm clothing and coats. And so if you have some coats while you're cleaning out that closet, changing over your clothes, and you can bring them in, you can drop them in the box right at the front of the community center for the Lions Clubs, and they will get them distributed to people in need of coats. So those are your used, gently used clothing that you have. And the last thing is, those of you who might not have watched the selectman meeting, they have announced some holidays, so please watch our website. We will post the upcoming holidays for Thanksgiving and the December season. And really, my last thing, I promise, whew, they're not going to let me in here anymore.
Oh, yeah, sure we will. You always can come in. Yeah.
That's because I have a key. is that on December 8th, the community center is only open for voting, which means that no other activities are happening in the building.
It's November 8th, right?
Yes, did I not say that? I probably didn't. November 8th, my goodness. It's been a long few days. So for our election day, we are only voting in this building. So no other events, not the weight room, nothing else is open. So please mark your calendars. I know that they'll be doing other updates and things like that, but I wanted to make sure people knew we don't have yoga or any of those things. If you have any questions on that, please don't hesitate to call the community center. I know our number will appear below us or someplace around us. 508-430-7568. Thank you again for the Halloween. Thank you for your donations to the troops. If you can drop off a winter coat that you're not using or you outgrew, children's, adults, anyone's, very helpful. And I think that's all my updates.
Well, very good. They're all very good. And I encourage everybody to check around in your own home and find some of this stuff and bring it in. And thank you, Carolyn, for coming in.
Well, you know, Carolyn always does such a great job, and, you know, she said, well, there weren't quite as many kids this year, but she said, maybe 200. Well, I'd say that's a pretty good number of kids here at Halloween.
Yes, definitely, and it's a nice, safe way to celebrate the holiday, and people really appreciate that she does this.
It's a wonderful, wonderful thing, plus all the other things that are going on here at the Community Center. It's just a wonderful program, all in all.
Yes, it
everything
is.
That happens
she does
here.
A great job, Carolyn.
She really does. Yeah. And well, we reminded you about this one last week, but again, we'll just run over this. As you know, there's a lot of road construction going on here around the town. And just a reminder that there's a project going on at Route 28 and Division Street, and that's going to be taking place on the 4th of November. Let's see, 4th of November.
That's tomorrow.
That's tomorrow.
Yeah,
that's
Friday.
Right, yeah. So just be aware of it. Just be patient. They're going to be doing some repaving. I guess they're laying some new pipes. I think a lot of it is gas pipes. They're replacing some of the old gas pipes. So that's a good thing. Nice to have fresh new gas pipes.
Yes, it certainly is.
So
that's worth the inconvenience, right, Jack?
Yeah, it is. It's definitely worth the inconvenience. And let's see, there's another one at, Route 28 and Division. And there's another one, 3 days is going to be to do that one. So I guess that's the most of it. So just be aware.
Within the next week.
Within the next week. And I noticed up there as we were coming in this morning, they had the road blocked off. It's down to one lane over there. And just be aware that it'll be all done. And then, you know, they pave it over quite nicely. So just be patient. The traffic isn't as bad now. So when they're done, we'll have all new gas pipes. So that's a good
right.
thing.
That's right. That's right. And it's mostly in the West Harwich area right now.
Yeah, right now it is. Yeah. So that's good. So you have an open mic night there?
Yes, I sure do. The Cape Cod Theater Company, which is also the home of the Harwich Junior Theater, is presenting open mic night on Friday, which is tomorrow, November 4th, from 7 to 10 p.m. Open mic night includes music, poetry, visual art, dance, and drama. And it will be featuring Bill Quack, I hope I'm pronouncing his name correctly, from 8:30 to 9 p.m. And that's on Friday, November 4th, at the Art Center on Sisson Road at the Harwich Center, in Harwich Center, and all ages of $5 at the door. And just remember that all proceeds of these open mic nights go to the Biddy Bop Scholarship Fund, a very good.
That is a wonderful fund.
Yes, it
gives a lot of kids opportunity to get their feet wet in theater. And
and they wouldn't normally be able to do it.
They wouldn't normally be able to do it. So that is a good opportunity there, definitely.
Okay.
And you've got something else there that's interesting.
I do, yes. You know, we're so lucky here in Harwich. The recreation program is having Saturday night open gym night starting on Saturday, November 19th. So mark your calendar. It's not coming yet, but we just want you to mark your calendar and have that date saved. Saturday, November 19th from 5 to 9:30 p.m. Children under 12 must have adult supervision. And it's a free Harwich recreation program. And again, Eric does a great job with all
of
the programs he provides.
He really does. And gives the kids an opportunity and gives them something to do.
In a nice, safe environment.
That's right.
Yes.
And well-structured. So
yes.
That's a good
thing. That's always a good thing, too.
Very true. Okay. We announced this also last week, but again, we'd like to remind you that the Harwich United Methodist Church will have its annual turkey dinner for $12 on Saturday, November 12th, starting at 5:30 p.m., and children 12 and under, $6. And for that very reasonable price, you get turkey, stuffing, gravy, mashed potatoes, roasted squash, turnip, peas, and pie. Boy, that's a deal.
Wow.
That is a deal. And that's going to be taking place in their fellowship hall, located at 1 Church Street in Harwich. If you need more information, you can call 508-432-3734. That's the Harwich United Methodist Church, the Big Turkey Dinner on Saturday, November 12th, starting at 5:30. So that's
like
an opportunity.
Great take.
That sounds like a really a great take. And we'd like to move now to some good information here, the COA voting information. With Barbara Ann and Kevin Considine. They're going to tell us about Council on Aging voting info. So I think this is an important one.
Oh, it
so
certainly is.
Let's take a look at that right now.
Well, hi, everyone. It's Barbara Ann again, and I have with me the wonderful Kevin Considine from the Harwich Police Department. And we're going to talk just briefly to give you an update on what's going to happen on November 8th when you come to the election. So my end of things is we will have our Cranberry Coach van available at 508-241-1566 to pick you up. You do not have to be a person who regularly rides it. If you're looking to avoid traffic and you just want to be brought there and back, the van can do that. You just need to call that number ahead of time and get on his schedule. And they will bring you right to the actual voting booths. So What will happen this year, we have our little golf carts that are going to be at the recreation side of the building. And we've heard your complaints from the past that have been, oh my gosh, I parked over on the COA side and I walked over to vote and now I have to walk all the way back. I can't go through the building. Unfortunately, the answer is no, you can't go back through the building. So we recommend a couple of things. Either if you've got a cane or any assistive device or need help, we can certainly take you by wheelchair. We have volunteers that will be there ready and willing to serve. And we'll bring you right in. You get in earlier, actually. And you'll go in to vote. They'll wait standby. And then as soon as you're done voting, they'll take you back in the wheelchair, either to your car directly. Or this year, we have the two golf carts. So you can hop in the golf cart and get a ride back to your car. So you won't be stranded and having to walk all the way back, is my point. We also will have volunteers at the entrance of the building. The only entrance you'll be able to come through is the main walkway entrance. There will not be entrance on the COA side or the other side. We'll have designated places that you'll come in and come through the building, and we'll get you back out through the gymnasium. So that being said, we will have people that will be there with precinct books, and you will say, they'll ask you if you know your precinct, and if you say, I'm not sure, they'll say, what is your street? And you'll give them the street and they'll tell you your precinct. So they will be at the entrance to be helpful to all of you, as well as our little wheelchair brigade people, to be able to bring you where you need to go. I do hear all the time, I'm fine. I use a cane, but I'm fine. It's okay. I don't need a wheelchair. What I would say to you is, we hopefully will get you in and out, but we just don't know what the turnout will be. We know that it's going to be large, and we had about 8,000 people come through the last presidential election. We do have a number who have already done, you know, the absentee and early voting, but we still could have a very large number of people, which could mean that you would be needing to wait in a line. And we don't have chairs for you to be able to sit in, you know, regular chairs along the way. So we will recommend, as we see you, please do not be have any hurt feelings. We do not mean any harm by it. We only want to be helpful to bring you to be able to get in there faster to vote and safely so that nobody falls. So the parking lot will be manned by our wonderful Harwich Police Department. And Kevin's going to tell you a little bit about what they're going to be doing and what their role is here.
Thank you, Barbara Ann. For the 8 hours in the morning and afternoon and then the evening hours, we have five officers on duty to assist each shift. So five in the morning, five in the afternoon, into the evening. We're going to have three outside assisting the volunteers with any way we can help out and assisting with parking. And we'll have two inside also assisting everybody inside. As far as parking goes, we'll be assisting in the parking lot. However, there's going to be ample parking across the street at the high school with shuttle bus service from the high school also. So I believe this parking lot will probably fill up quickly. So if able, the best place to park, if this is filled, is the high school, and there's ample parking over there. At night, we're going to have the road lit up, and we're going to have officers assisting people crossing the road. So we shouldn't have any issue with parking, and there's no school that day, so there'll be plenty of parking. Also on Oak Street, on both sides of the road, we're going to have the orange temporary no parking signs posted, and we're not going to allow any parking on the side of the road on Oak Street. That just causes issues with people parking on the sidewalks, and then people that want to walk up to the community center can't do that. So just be cognizant of any no parking, temporary no parking zones in the area. And also, as in every year with town meeting and or elections, the campaigning around the building, we keep a careful eye on. There's a state law which you cannot campaign 100 feet from the entrance to the voting area. So for us here at the community center, as usual, it's not changing, but the very entrance of each driveway, both on the council and aging side and the rec side, is the designated spot for campaigning. So officers are cognizant to keep an eye on that And for the most part, that, you know, we have no issues with that, but we just want to put that out there that we will be watching where that campaigning is taking place, and we appreciate everybody's support in that.
The other thing with the campaigning piece that we want to remind people of is, and we will be enforcing, is there is also no hats, no pins, no campaigning on your body, basically, once you enter inside our building. The other piece that apparently is a new phenomenon, I can't even imagine doing this, but is cell phones. People trying to take selfies and do other things while you're in the booth. That's actually illegal. So we would urge you to make sure if you have to have a cell phone on you that it's either off or on silent and that you don't touch it during the time that you're in the gymnasium. If you are seen or a person is seen doing that, they will immediately be spoken to by the town clerk because it is a law and it is breaking the law. So we just want to urge everybody to make sure. We know people have cell phones. We're not telling you can't have a cell phone. We just want to make sure that nobody's using them when they're in the polls or in the gymnasium, and that people aren't wearing hats or pins or paraphernalia that are on your body that are campaigning. So please follow those rules. And we're looking for a safe event, an exciting event, and obviously you'll be standing by for results. So we will be here for the duration, as will the Harwich Police Department. And if you have any questions, don't hesitate to call us. Again, the van phone is 508-241-1566. Thank you very much for tuning in.
And some great information there from Barbara Ann and from Officer Considine.
Yes.
Very good.
Yes.
Yes.
And connected to that piece is the announcement that on November 8th, the community center here is only open for voting. Nothing else is going to be going on. So if you're not voting, stay home. All classes and events are canceled for that day, and the weight room will be closed as well.
Yeah, so that's an important one to note, you know, the community center just for voting.
Just for voting, yeah. On November 8th.
Yeah, very
Tuesday,
good.
Next Tuesday.
That's right, it's coming.
It's almost here,
it's
so
almost
those
here.
Of you that didn't vote early.
Get out and vote.
Yes.
Everybody should vote that's yes. eligible to vote.
Yes, especially in this election, very important.
Yeah. And you got another one there, Eileen?
I do.
Yeah.
The Monomoy Cooperative Learning Programs are being presented by the Monomoy Regional School District. They are looking for enrichment instructors. They are looking for new and innovative classes for students in grades K through 4th after school in Chatham and in Harwich. If you have experience teaching and would like to share your talent, please send a proposal to this email. And the girl's name is Ann Emerson, who is the director of the Monomoy Cooperative Learning Programs. And her email, I will spell it, is AEMERSON at monomoy.edu by November 30th. Or you can mail it to capital letters, capital M, capital C, capital L, capital P, P.O. Box 759, Harwichport, Mass. 02646.
Very good.
So if you have teaching experience and you'd like to help enrich the students in kindergarten through grade 4, please get in touch with Ann Emerson.
Yeah, that's a great opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it's nice to have. That's after-school enrichment?
Yes.
Yeah, that's sort of a nice
yes.
thing to do.
It is, and yeah. you can follow them on Facebook, too, at capital L, capital C, capital L, capital P.
On Facebook. Okay, very good.
Yes.
And here is a reminder, you know, Veterans Day is right around the corner, and the town of Harwich always does have a wonderful Veterans Day ceremony. And at Island Pond Cemetery, of course, on November 11th at 11 a.m., there'll be a welcome, there'll be a Pledge of Allegiance by the Harwich Scouts. The invocation will be offered by Reverend Jim David. There'll be greetings by Selectman Janelle Brown. The speaker this year will be Sergeant Jeremy Armstrong from the U.S. Army National Guard. Benediction will be offered by Reverend Jim David, and taps will be played by Alex Tapier, and I hope I pronounced your name right, Alex. And, you know, this is an opportunity to remember our veterans. And, again, that's on Veterans Day, November 11th. Which is a national holiday, at 11 a.m. at Island Pond Cemetery. So I hope we have a good weather day that
yes,
day.
Yes, I hope so.
Yeah, that would be great. Well, folks, I hope you've enjoyed our show. That is our show for this week, and hope to see you again next week. Thank you so much for joining us on behalf of all of us here at Channel 18. We appreciate that very much.
Yes, and please, I hope you've marked down all of these dates because there's a lot going on around town. And please remember to support the Garden Club of Harwich on Saturday, December 3rd from 9:30 to 1 right here at the Community Center.
And as Paul always says, and all of the activities, please do so safely.
Absolutely.
Take care, everybody. Bye-bye for now.